Hey guys, it is Mrs. Clough. I want to talk to you guys a little bit about what we can expect. So this year, we are being asked to do a lot, both you as a student and as a family, and your teachers are being asked to do a lot that we aren't used to yet either. And so there's not a whole lot that we can predict or that we can expect is always going to go as planned. Like, that's just not how it's going to go. But we do have to have some expectations in place as we get started so that we know kind of what we want from each other as teacher and student. So there are a few things that I think are important baselines for us to get started. And hopefully we'll have a chance to put together some of this information together, and you guys will be able to contribute to what we expect as a class. But for now, there are a few things that I think we can all agree on. So there are really three main things that I think we can agree on how we're going to treat each other in digital formats all across the board, whether you're typing to someone or on video or anything like that. So one is be kind. Everyone is figuring stuff out, right? We've got lots of different situations with jobs, with teaching, with learning, with computers. Lots of different people have lots of different levels of comfort with that. And we just don't have time to treat each other badly. We're all trying to figure this out and we want to use our energy well. So don't treat each other badly. It's a waste of energy that we could be using to like solve other problems. Okay. We also want to make sure that you're trying your best. I'm going to fail sometimes. Hi, I am a human. I make mistakes. I'm going to fail at something at some point this year. It might be this video, right? It might be a failure. I don't know. But I'm going to be here every day and I'm going to continue to work hard, just as hard, if not harder, than I would be working if you were sitting in my classroom right now. And so wherever you are, whatever you have, please, please try your best. Okay, and the third thing that I think we can all agree on is ask for help. Okay, there have been things that I didn't know how to do that I reached out for other teachers to get help on. There are things that other teachers will reach out and ask me about. And the same goes for you as students, right? If you do not understand something about Canvas in a video meeting or a chat or anything, email me, reach out in whatever way you can to ask that question, because I can't answer a question that I don't know exists, and I can't find the answer to a question that I don't know exists. So we're gonna be kind, try our best, and ask for help. So what should we do each day? Okay, so everything right now is in an online format, and that is, you know, super new. It might continue, it might not, we don't know. There's all sorts of different stuff. So what should I do? So we're starting online. You're gonna log into Canvas if you can, okay? If Canvas and those sorts of things go down, we're gonna have a backup plan to email you information so that you know what to do, okay? But every day we wanna try to log into Canvas. Okay, notice if you have been asked to show up to a meeting, meaning try to log in and connect over a video or audio, right? You don't have to turn your video on, you don't have to turn your audio on necessarily, but to show up to that meeting. So if you have a meeting, try to show up to it. And so you will find a link for that either in Canvas or an email from me, okay? We're not going to start off with having Teams meetings all the time. We're going to try and ease into that. So I will let you know when that changes. Okay. Again, what do I do each day? Pay attention to the announcements in Canvas. If something is new and I need to update you, I'm going to post an announcement and you're going to be able to see that. Okay. That's a direct notice from me on what to do, where to go, how to get there. I am going to post as many just like click here links as humanly possible to make things simple for you. But I might also post some tutorial videos to show you how to access different things. Okay. But we do want to be flexible and say like, okay, we have to change really quickly on the fly because something didn't work out. Okay. So be prepared for that. Look at the weekly learning plan. We're going to send out a way for you to know how we're supposed to take attendance, how we're going to check to make sure you're participating. Pay attention to what that is and know what you need to complete in order to get as much credit as possible. Okay, so when we're on Canvas, what are our expectations on Canvas? Read the information on Canvas. Okay, I cannot possibly create a video for every single step. There are going to be some things that I'm going to put in as text directions. Please, please read them. If you see something there, read it. If you have a question, go back to that page and read it first, because there's going to be information there that's going to help you navigate that. Okay, so make sure you're reading everything. Okay, if you see something to participate in, the expectation is that you participate in it, right? Like if there's a Flipgrid posted and you need to do a video and post that, right? You can put an emoji over your face. You don't have to put your face on it, but participate in that. Okay, if there's a discussion, add your thoughts. If there's a Nearpod and it gives you like a multiple choice question, answer the question. Right? Those are the kinds of things that we're going to be looking for. Okay. All of your participation in any of these things should be a school appropriate, on topic, and kind, right? As exciting as your little sister's Barbie doll is, it probably doesn't pertain to English class. So if we're putting a discussion board and we're like typing an answer, maybe that's not what we add. Okay. But it really boils down to two things. And this goes for my whole class all the time, forever. Work hard and be nice. I'm going to do my best to do those two things, and I want you to do your best to do those two things. Okay? When we do get to the point where we video call in the program called Microsoft Teams, there are a few things to remember. You want to be logged in with your school account, which means you're going to go through that single sign-on portal. I will post links. Okay? And video is great if you're comfortable with it and if your computer, if your Chromebook and your internet can handle it. If you're struggling, like if you're noticing that the video is getting real like robot-y or pixely, turn off the video. It's okay, right? That will take up less space on your Chromebook and it will actually make it work faster if that's a struggle that you're having, okay? When we're in a Teams meeting, it's just like being in classroom with 30 people. If you all try to talk at once, no one gets heard. So keep your mic muted unless I say differently. Again, keep your conversation class specific and kind, okay? And if we can do those things, we'll be golden. Okay, so what next? You found out a little bit about me. If you're seeing this in Canvas, which hopefully you are, hopefully things are going well, you know these expectations, you've seen them. There should be a next button in your bottom right-hand corner in Canvas, and that'll take you to the next thing you need to participate in. Well, welcome to my class. Have a great day.